I want to start, first of all, by the vision of Tsinoga. Tsinoga's vision from 2004 was that there will be a time whereas the patient is going to measure himself at home, and you spoke about it before, and not come to the hospital or to the clinic or to the doctor, whatever it is. This was the vision from then. I'd like to go back even further. I'd like to go back 100 years, 200 years. If you remember, once upon a time, a doctor used to look at the patient and say, you've got a heart problem, you've got a liver problem. How did that person do it? How did that doctor know to say such things? He basically looked at the face and said, I'm looking at the color. That's what he was taught. That's what he knew. There weren't any devices, and that's what he had to rely on. Of course, there were other measurements that he took and other symptoms that he looked at, but in essence, that's what he did. Tsinoga started out, like I said, in 2004, when our CEO, Dr. Yosef Segman, went on something totally different, went for 2 years to China. Over the weekend, he was bored, and he started taking pictures of people's faces. He took those faces, and because he's a doctor of mathematics, he wasn't interested in what the actual picture looked like, but was interested in what's behind the picture, in the numbers that are behind the picture. And then he started downloading pictures of faces from all over the world and said, is there a correlation between different races, different colors, and different pigmentation? What's going on? And he found something that was exactly the same with all races, colors, and sexes, whatever it is. And he started to develop the system whereas he took pictures of people's faces and could determine different parameters, bioparameters. The next step he went and he said, okay, if I can do that on the face, that means that I can take a picture of the cell, the blood cells, and where's the best place to do it? In the finger. And he actually took he bought his wife a ring, and he took the box, the hard box, and he cut out the one side, put a camera in, and started taking pictures of the actual blood tissue through the finger. He then went to Texas Instruments, and he said, I can work out, and I can tell you what the parameters are of, he looked at blood pressure, he looked at pulse, he looked at glucose, and they sort of thought, yeah, this madman came from Israel, he got to the States, and they said, you know what, let's do a trial. We'll put a physician in one room, we'll put you in another, let's test, let's have a look. And what happened in the end, I'm going to cut the story short now because I only have 3 minutes, 36 seconds, what happened in the end was that they invested quite a bit of money in it, and 40% of our devices, which is this today, has Texas Instruments in it. Our devices that we have today, first of all, I'd like to say that the innovations that we bring to the market and what we're bringing to humanity, let's say, the first time presenting the idea of using video sensors in order to measure different parameters. The device is small for home use. Put in the bag, put in your purse, put it wherever you want. And let's say what everybody's looking for, it's the first real glucometer, non-invasive glucometer that has been commercialized. We do have CE mark for all our products. We have started marketing and selling our devices at very, very early stages. We are coming out with version 2. We are, at the moment, targeting type 1 diabetics. If we look at the family, the Tensitive family that we have, we've got the VSM, the Vital Signs Monitor. We have the glucometer. We have the MTX. You can read a little bit more about it, first of all, on the screen. Number two, you can visit us and see what we have to show you. Something else that I just, you know, it's got nothing to do with medical, but just to show you what our technology can actually do. when you buy wine today, you go to the supermarket or you go to the wine store and you say, I want wine. You have no idea what you want, but you want something that you like. We have the ability today with this technology to actually take your cell phone, put it onto the wine bottle and say, yes, this is what you like. Because we know how to measure what the parameters that you like. That's all I have to say. I hope I impressed you. And open for questions.
We are very efficient today. We also have 1 minute to go. So after
we were
six
threatened.
Minutes... Okay, Dr. Tilmandry, would you like to ask a question?
Yes, indeed. I think this is, in fact, a very interesting technology. But how would you commercialize? How would you lately bill this service?
Okay, if we're talking, I should imagine you're talking about the glucometer, correct? The glucometer or in general?
The product itself.
Sorry?
The service or the product itself. How is it commercialized?
Well, no, we don't sell a service. We're selling devices. So there's no implementation of a service.
And is this something which people pay out of the pocket, or would it be reimbursed by social security systems?
Okay, at the moment, it's out of the pocket. It's new, it's innovative, it's going to take a few years for the reimbursement mechanisms around the world to kick in.
Mr. Barona.
Interesting. There have been a number of other attempts to develop non-invasive monitor or detector of glucose level. What is the data that you have that suggests that this is better than everything else that we have seen to date?
Well, first of all, the technology that we use is a different technology than what has been used up until today. I'm not going to get into exactly what that is, but it's a totally different approach to the monitoring and actually the analyzing of the information that we get. Further than that, we have a procedure within the device that the user actually sees non-invasive together with invasive together and obtains basically the comfort that this device is actually working. And because that's one of the biggest worries in the diabetic market, that you're going to be giving a device that doesn't work, it hasn't been proven on that person. And that we've solved with what we call the calibration process.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Suzman. Okay.